Hello friends, welcome back to my gaming channel New York. So let's continue on our gameplay walkthrough of Twin Mirror. In the last video, our character suddenly, after drinking at the bar, suddenly woke up at a hotel in the morning and found out that he had blood all over his shirt. He feared that he might have killed someone. And then he went back to the bar and investigated what had happened and found that he just had a big fight with Dennis. I think that's what his name is. And Dennis told that something was not okay, something was not as it seemed about Nick. So, but he told him to meet him somewhere. So that he can tell what happened, what is the truth. And although Sam does not trust Dennis, but he wants to figure out what happened with Nick. Means because something was amiss, like it was not a simple, it does not look like a simple accident at least. It feels like he has been murdered. And also, so Sam comes to check on Dennis, and also he has a meet up to catch up with Anna. So before that, he has still some time, so he comes to pay a visit to Dennis. Okay, let's continue after that. We checked all this stuff, sir. What else we can find around here? Before we go there, Dennis's car. If his car is here, Dennis can't be far.
Never knew Dennis to be the commemorative type. What's he doing here?
Who has his name written on the number plate? Dennis's license plate. Who else but Dennis would have a license plate like that? Like the true creative he is. He spelled the S in his name with a dollar sign. Joan never misses an opportunity to point out how lame it is. For once, I agree. Remember the one time Dennis took you out for a beer? It was your first week at the Basswood jungle. He set up your computer, gave you your password, and asked if you wanted a drink. He joked that people only drank with him once on their first day. He even provided an explanation. After that, they know I am an asshole. It's only later you learn that his wife had left him and their two children. You actually saw glimpses of him being a good dad when his children were around, but he made it his pride to be the sarcastic, grumpy IT guy to everyone else, and nothing spells bitterness like a license plate with a dollar sign at the end. So, this is a memento for Dennis, the only one there is. So there's nothing back here. I don't see anything. Black Heart Hotel. Closed hotel. Built during the minimum mining coal golden age of 70s, was bound to close. Am I supposed to go through here? I don't think I am supposed to go through here. No options are popping up also. What about here? Nothing's coming up here even. What is this sign? Many companies left town.
At least the Basswood jungle is still standing.
Basswood jungle. A small publication with a loyal following. First and only real job.
It's not worth it. No one works on a Sunday. Well, no one except me.
Okay, that was his first real job.
No luck so far, but I should keep digging around. Someone must have seen Dennis.
Nothing further here. What about the outside of the road?
Now, I can't just have you hanging around here all day like a ghost.
It's a free country.
Hey, don't give me that. People have been complaining, so don't let me see you here again.
You fascist.
What you just... I'm just doing my job. It's nothing personal.
Looks like you're not the only one who started off on the wrong foot today.
Sorry you had to see that. Some people you just can't reason with. Speaking of, you're still in town.
Who is that? Didn't any student? Let's ask, who is that?
That person you were talking to? Who's that?
A lost soul. Vagrancy isn't a crime, but loitering and trespassing are. I try to be understanding, polite, but it's hard when no one is polite back.
Card shot, listen.
People call
listen,
you listen. Pig or fascist just for doing your job. Then they go and do things like deface the whole town. And I'm the asshole? It could get under your skin. Where's you at day after day? It grinds you down. It makes you feel like you've been lifting logs all day. Nah, sorry about that. I went off for a spell. Just remember, this town don't always respect the things you do.
Trust me, I know.
Seen Dennis today?
You haven't seen Dennis today, have you?
Why are you looking for him?
I wanted to apologize for last night.
I'll just stay out of his way for a day or two. I heard you messed up Dennis pretty good last night. I'm not judging. His head's full of smoke. Takes a while to clear it out.
I don't want to keep you, officer. Have a good day.
Keep your nose clean.
Journal updated. Declan. He seems more confident than how I remember him, but also more frustrated.
Declan always had very clear ideas about law and order, but now he seems to be even more vocal about his convictions.
Sorry, Sam, I'm still on duty. I wouldn't want anyone making off with a statue on Miner's Day, huh?
Graffiti goes to show, not all graffiti is the work of Handel.
You know you're in Basswood when even the graffiti's about miners.
Miner graffiti. Miner's Day used to be the big family day outweighing the Basswood. Your dad would take you to see the town center. You have to sit on his shoulders to see the marching bands or the musicians on the stand. There was a cotton candy and a donut machine in front of the old hotel. Balloons and pinwheels and sticky fingers and laughters everywhere. In the evening, the lookout point would be littered with teenagers making out. Miner's Day was the glue that held the town together. It ran in people's blood, even in yours. It's what makes Joe still come here, staring at the miner statue for hours on end. It allows him to see the proud community Basswood was, standing tall in the Appalachian Mountains instead of down on its luck town it became. Once a mining town, always a mining town, they say. Joe is Anna's father and a former miner. Okay, this is his memento. House for sale. John was already trying to sell it 4 years ago. Gravity looks fresh, artistic value debatable.
Didn't used to see this around. Surprised it hasn't been removed.
I can't talk to this guy. I don't think I can go.
No luck so far, but I should keep digging around. Someone must have seen Dennis.
What is this? Drugstore. Kathy's workplace was on the brink of closing 2 years ago.
Maybe Kathy will know something. Or that new pharmacist.
Spaceship ride. 50 cents for 1 minute of escapism. Used to be 25 cents.
A perfect toy for a kid who only had imaginary friends.
I'll check this later. Because I think that's where Dennis will be. Prats and Dunes, Anna's favorite shop. She came here every month for the LP section. Job wanted. Handyman for a hire.
I imagine there's a lot more people looking for work nowadays.
Flexible hours and pay schedule. Good with tools and hard work. Fix, paint, move, anything. Won't do roofs or electric wiring. Email tylership@basswoodwv.loa. This looks like a restaurant of sorts. Employee.
She pulls the look off a lot better than I could.
Hey, don't remember seeing you in town before. Passing by?
Passing through. I am from here.
I was born in Basswood. I was raised in Basswood, though I left for a few years.
Wait, you managed to leave and still came back? You'd never see me again if I left.
Why don't you then?
Yeah, sure. I'm just gonna take my millions of dollars and make a run for it. I can barely get by, like everyone else here. Too poor to stay, too poor to leave.
Slow day so far.
She pulls the look off a lot better than I could.
Starts. I guess it means more tips for me, so it's not all bad.
Add retrospective. The history of Basswood.
Somehow, I don't think the town's recent history will be included. It's fine with me.
The history of Basswood. Have you ever wondered how Basswood got its name and went from a small mining camp to the heart and modernized boon country? Join us at your favorite town hall and find out.
Remember when this whole celebration used to be twice as big? Back when this town wasn't just a dead horse we all keep kicking. Why do we even bother with this old place? Feels like a ghost town sometimes, except the ghosts haven't bothered leaving.
Gossip Club, 2 mouths but half an ear, one set in every hometown. Looks like we can't talk to them. I don't want to go in the cafe right now because Dennis might be there. I want to see everything so that I don't miss anything.
No luck so far, but I should keep digging around.
Okay, can't
talk. Someone must have seen Dennis.
Barricades set up to regulate traffic during the miners' celebration. Miner statue, just another relic.
A statue honoring miners. Pretty meaningless now.
Joe.
Losing his legs seemed like the end of him, but he bounced back. Man, he's a rock. Joe.
Sam? You old bridge jumper, how you been? What's the calendar say?
2 years, Joe. It's been 2 years.
Too long. I heard you showed up yesterday. The boys give you trouble?
Nothing I couldn't handle.
They might have given me a bit of a welcome back.
After the mine closed, well, it ain't easy to put food on the table. Don't let that weigh on you. No one else has lost their legs recently.
Why weren't you at the wake?
I noticed you weren't at the bar last night.
Went home after the service. Being crippled takes it out of you. Normally, I'd be rotting away in my recliner, but I like to come out, see the decorations, pay my respects to old iron here. This town's been a mining town before I was born, and it'll be one after I die. It's good to get out and celebrate your roots every now and then.
I don't have the same perspective on Miner's Day that other people have.
No, I suppose you wouldn't.
How have you been?
So, how have you been holding up?
Terribly. But Anna keeps me young. How'd you ever let her get away?
You probably know better than me.
I heard all about it. Still, I always liked you. Straight shooters are a rare breed these days. I like a man that can look me in the eye and say what he means.
You seen Dennis today?
You haven't seen Dennis today, have you?
I wish. Just about the only guy I could talk hockey with.
Not football?
I want to talk football. I can just grab anybody on the street. Dennis actually enjoys a man sport. But no, I haven't seen him.
I gotta get going.
I have places I need to be, but it's good to see you.
Just promise you won't wait 2 years before saying boo again.
I'll do my best. Joe has no idea where Dennis went. Someone must have seen him after the fight.
Joe, it was Joe's accident that led me to write the article right about the miner. And yet, he doesn't hold a grudge for that or for letting his daughter drown. Part of me likes to believe he sees me as a good man. The other part knows the contempt is just hidden deep. I read this. Nicole. Too poor to stay, too poor to leave. It would make a good headline for an article. Anna should write about Nicole, the real Bassword story.
Losing his legs seemed like the end of him, but he bounced back. Man, he's a rock.
Miner's Day again. Always brings up a bad memory.
This is new. Domations. Now that's the Basswood I remember.
Basswood mine opened 1975, closed 2015. Paid for by the donations of William Jackson. That would be donations. Okay, that's why we pointed out donations. William Jackson, Walter Dodson, Hugh Kirkland, Robert Paulson, Vivica, Winnicott, Richard Greenlee, Ethan Morrow, John Brooks, and Nick Waldron. Who's this guy? But first, let's inspect the flick.
Never forget, huh?
20,000 men marched through Guni country to reach Blair Mountain in 1921 where they fought for what we have now. Nothing worth having is not worth fighting for.
Hey, can I ask you something?
Hello, young man. And of course you can ask. No promise answering.
Why do you bother cleaning the memorial?
Well, everything has to look its best for today. Especially the miner. I really didn't think it was going to happen this year. Good thing Mr. Kirkland decided to help out. And besides, that way people can remember with pride we used to be rednecks.
That matters to you?
It should matter to every West Virginian.
How so?
And why do you think it should matter so much?
How many West Virginians does it take to screw in a light bulb?
This doesn't sound like a history lesson.
You answer my question, I'll answer yours. So, how many West Virginians?
Two.
Two. One to hold the light bulb, the other to rotate the planet.
Not bad. The one I have in store is three. One to replace the light bulb, two to complain about how the old one was better.
Good one, maybe too accurate, but you ever fail that way.
That might be a little too close to home.
My favorite jokes have always been the ones that make me feel a little sad. So, you still want to hear the story?
Sure.
I'm all ears.
This fella here is a reminder of when coal miners stood together. You see, back 100 years ago, you'd be safer in the trenches than down in the mines. It didn't sit right with our boys. They demanded better conditions. Of course, the corporations, being what they are, refused and sent strikebreakers.
The mine wars. Miners came out in force, union men. Met the strikebreakers over in Logan County.
That's right. 10,000 strong. And it all came to a head at Blair Mountain. The miners tied red bandanas around their necks for solidarity. Brotherhood. At least 100 men died in that battle. Blood spilled for what we have now. Oh.
You respect them.
I'm guessing you're fond of that story, huh? A lot of respect for rednecks.
Well, things were tough, but we were a united community back then. Anyway, I get back to it. Gonna give her a real spit shine. You take care now. Sorry, I really need to finish this. These old hands can't be idle.
Okay. Like, mine's this.
Drowned six men. Basswood's mining started with an accident. Fitting.
Coal River Mine opened in 1854, closed in 1861 after the flood drowned six men. West Shadow Mine opened 1866, closed 1892, top producer in Boone Country for 5 years. Deep Rock Mine opened in 1890, closed 1926. Sweetwater Mine opened 1915, closed 1920. Smoky Hole Mine opened 1928, closed 1976. Okay, that's with that. Let's move on our quest to find Dennis. Oh, that's Joan. Mark Twain Port. Good to see the younger generation open to classics. Joan.
Now doesn't seem like the best time to bother her.
But I'll still bother her.
Hey, Bug. What are you doing out here?
Hey, Muley. Waiting for my mom to get off her shift at the pharmacy. Drawing. I got a new journal after I left the old one somewhere. See?
Did you get home okay last night?
Yeah. I bike everywhere. It's not like anything scary bad happens in Basswood. At least not normally. I heard you asking about my dad last night.
I guess I wasn't very subtle.
Well, I guess I wasn't very subtle, was I?
No, you were not. Did you find out anything about my dad?
Not yet. Not really, at least.
Let me know if you find anything, please. I feel like I need something. It's just this town, you know? This place. It feels like I'm suffocating. I can't breathe. I can't think. I can't stand my mom. I don't like school. Well, except for science. And just when I imagine myself in the future, I just don't. I don't know. I don't see this place or these people. I'm somewhere else. Anywhere else. I know it's stupid, just...
It's not stupid. If you want, you can go anywhere in the world. Have adventures, fall in love. I mean, that's what I've been told anyway.
Gross! Okay, well, that other stuff sounds okay, though. Thanks for listening.
I got grown-up stuff I gotta do.
I've got kid stuff I gotta see about. So we're both busy.
It's tough seeing her like this. Seems she got older by 6 years in just 2.
I guess I can't ask her about Dennis again.
I'll be fine. Just waiting for my mom's shift to end.
Let's enter the drugstore. I don't know if I can check the other restaurant again.
Yo, get out the way.
Sorry.
Sorry about that.
Yeah, yeah. Asshole.
That's enough.
I don't know how to pick up fight, so...
Kathy and Hugh were both at the wake. I should talk to them.
Power wheelchair, better have insurance.
Not uncommon for minors to end up in those once they get black lungs.
Painkillers, never there when needed. That's right, never there when needed. Sleeping pills need to be taken with caution. That is also right, Tara.
Oh, Sam, you here to pick up something for your condition?
I have a condition.
Yeah, the one that makes you the way you're always so... you. It's all right, of course. I won't tell anyone. I think I might actually have leaky gut. It's where your intestine starts to dissolve, and your half-digested food starts to leak out into your blood. I'm trying to find something for it, and if it doesn't help, can't hurt. I'm glad someone took over this old drugstore. Can you imagine? This town without a pharmacy would be like, well, me with a hole in my gut. I'll just check the internet when I get home. It'll tell me what to get.
It was nice talking to you, Tara.
Oh, yes, always.
And I don't get to ask about Dennis. Okay, I have other people to ask, so no problem. bags of chips, junk food sold by a drugstore, counterintuitive.
Reminds me of a girl I met. She could only eat chips when she had stomach aches.
That's funny. Hiking trails, some of the best in the state.
Hiking is an activity best done alone on a Sunday afternoon.
Charity stuffed toy, emotional tragedy turned into a gift store item, effective. Anything else out here? Celebrity magazine, pure fluff journalism. Basswood postcard, best angle of Basswood you get. Kathy's glass jar, handmade gift made by Joan, ugly but cute.
Bug made that for Mother's Day years ago, and Kathy still keeps it with her.
It was a Mother's Day gift, painted glass. It was a Mother's Day gift. Kathy keeps it all these years, even though the colors have faded and her old boss grumbled that clutter didn't belong in a pharmacy. Even Joan said she wouldn't be upset to see it go, but Kathy will never throw it away. It's been there so long, it's taken on life of its own. Soon Joan will do that too, take on a life of her own. But that glass jar will stay with Kathy. With the candle inside that's never been lit and probably never will be. Why do I see so much of myself in that kid? Questioning, relentless, lonely, I wish I could prove it to her that she's wrong about everything. Her dad, Basswood, her life being a dead end, if only. That's not a memento for her. Yeah, that's what I want to talk about. Kathy. Candy bowl strategically displayed to make children feel better. Depression poster. About time it was addressed. Miner's Day ad. No mine, still a Miner's Day ad. Miner's Day. Tradition die hard in that.
Miner's Day always ends up exactly the same. Relaxing in its constancy.
Pharmacist diploma displayed to reassure customers. Huge. Okay, now I think it's time to start talking to these two people. I will start with Kathy.
Still here after all these years. She followed Nick to Basswood, but never liked it.
So I guess I can't talk to her, so I'll have to talk to you.
He looks like those doctors you see on commercials.
Ah, Samuel. Sorry about Richard. He's always a little on edge. I'm surprised to see you up and about after the night you had. Honestly, I was afraid you'd end up like your friend. You were quite inebriated.
I blacked out.
Honestly, I don't remember last night. You saw me blackout drunk. Not my finest hour.
I would say not. After your barroom brawl, I did my best to prevent you from following that other man outside. And I tried to get you to hand over your keys, but you would have none of it.
Sorry about that. The man I had a fight with, Dennis. Have you seen him today?
Seen him? No. No, can't say I have.
Thanks anyways.
That article you wrote, it's done this town a lot of good.
How?
How do you figure?
The mind was a band-aid on a torn artery. Sometimes, doing what is unpopular is still the moral choice.
You probably believe that.
I'd offer you something for that hangover, but I find in some cases, time is the best medicine.
Suggesting I take nothing, my mother says that I'm laying off him.
A A pill pusher who doesn't want to push pills. That's a new one.
Everything is poison. All that matters is the dose. Now, you have a good one, young man. Was there anything else you needed, by the way?
Why move to Basswood?
I have to ask, why move here, of all places? You know, here, Basswood. A blink and you miss this town. People move out of Basswood, not in.
The town I used to work in had 100 other pharmacies in it. Oh, you'd make sales. But you don't get to know anyone, ever. Plus, if I'm being honest, I always imagined I'd retire in a small mountain town.
You are involved in Minus 10?
I heard you're helping out with the celebration today.
Naturally. It's the town's biggest homegrown tradition. I've become quite a fan myself.
I never got into it.
No. A celebration of hard work and building something with your own two hands? Well, it's quite romantic. Not from Flores it myself, but it has that universal appeal.
If it works for you.
Samuel, I saw you talking to Walter. Can you ask him something from me?
Of course.
Sure thing. What is it?
I knew I could count on you. I was hoping the Basswood jungle could run a piece about me. You see, some of the older folks see me as an outsider still.
Can't say I'm surprised. I'll try and remember to ask next time I talk to him.
I really appreciated the chat, but I'm afraid it's time I get back to work. Do come see me again.
Journal updated. Hughes, he has a strong opinion on my article. Family believes it is a good thing. Maybe the only one in town. No coincidence he didn't grow up here.
He looks like those doctors you see on commercials.
I hope you'll stay for the festivities, Sammy.
Let's see if I can talk to Kathy now, yeah.
Hey, Kathy.
Yo, Sam. What can I do you for?
About the wake.
So, the wake.
None of us were on our best behavior. Nick would have been happy you showed up, no matter how anything else went. I left early myself to go check on Joan. Did you have to say that fantasy about her father being murdered was real?
That's not what I...
I just want her to be a little girl, not a little Sam Higgs. Sneaking around and getting into trouble. And now all she can talk about is how you're gonna prove that she's right. Sorry, I know it's not your fault, but I just don't... I don't know what to do with her. She's my daughter. And I feel like I'm losing her. I gotta go. If the boss sees me jawing instead of working, I'll get an earful.
No one in here was much help.
Why is it that I can ask the other questions later?
3 boxes of codeine. 5 tubes of anti-inflammatory gel. Say it.
You like to talk if you're still around. Working in the cafe most of the day, or you like to talk if you're still around. Oh, so she's in the cafe nearby. I have to go there ultimately.
Sorry, Sam, I'm still on duty.
I wouldn't want anyone making up.
Let's go to the cafe.
Ah, now I've gone and made a bit of a mess. Oh, Sam, is that you? Dear, please, could you help an old doddering woman?
You're not doddering, you're too careless.
You are many things, but not doddering. Plotting, maybe.
Sam, you shouldn't say such things, even if they're true.
Board game, the idea.
Thank you so much. You're always such a dear.
Say, Christina, have you...
Oh, Sam, it's been years. It really is so nice to see you again.
Yeah, likewise, but...
I wanted to come to the funeral yesterday, but just thinking about it, oh, dear.
Now, I know you want to interrupt her because I want to interrupt her. So eyes on me, buddy. Happy thoughts, deep breaths. Yeah, well, speaking of the...
Poor Joan, losing her father at such a young age. Oh, what a tragedy. I was trying to find one of those games she likes so much to cheer her up. Poor child only has Kathy now, and, well, far from me to criticize or anything, but his last...
Have you seen Dennis since yesterday?
Have you not learned to not interrupt people when they're talking, Sam?
I don't have time for small talk today.
As rude as ever. I haven't seen Dennis. You have a nice day.
I didn't want to sound rude, but she seemed like the kind of woman who would keep on talking.
Anna's here. I should talk to her.
Inquire about Dennis is over. Christina owns Cafe Americano just across the street from my old office. Anna, Nick, and I used to be regular. Christina knows everyone in town. She's the gossip hub of Basswood. Serves great coffee with a laughter that can be heard all the way across Basswood. At least it was like that in the oldest days. Christina loves to talk, but only on her terms. Straight answers are not her thing. Buttermilk biscuit was a good way to start the day with coffee. Christina
is Basswood's resident godmother. She loves her small talk.
Maybe I shouldn't have interrupted her.
The cost. Right, so the overhead would
be... You seem real engrossed.
Oh, I'm sorry, hon. Just balancing the books. Or trying to.
Coffee's still good?
Do you still have Basswood's best coffee?
Ah, honey, you know we've never had that. That's over at the police station. Bess takes her coffee very seriously. Puts mine to shame. She pays out of pocket for real high-end stuff. I'd never make the margins work. Not that my margins have been cutting it lately. Anyway, the past is the past. I just accepted a big business opportunity, which makes tidying up my books in time extra important, even if it kills me.
Got a franchise deal?
I didn't think I'd see the day where you'd consider a franchise contract.
Ha! Only the day God calls for me. Have you met Hugh Kirkland already? The new pharmacist. He's helping me with a few improvements. Angel investing. Can you believe it?
I actually can't. What did he ask for in return?
Oh, dear. I can't believe you're so cynical at your age. People in small towns do help each other. Every now and again. That's not just something that happens on made-for-TV movies.
How are the books looking?
How you doing? You managed to keep the books balanced?
About as well balanced as a snake with four balls.
That sounds uncomfortable, at the very least.
It's
Something my grandfather used to say. Still don't know what it means, but it works in almost any situation. It's just been a bit slow the last few years. All over town, really.
The town will... is it that bad?
Sounds like the town's running through a pretty rough patch.
Ah, things have just been a bit tough since the mine closed. But you know us. We always make it through. For example, I thought we'd never have another miner's day. But here we are.
It's been a while, hasn't it?
I feel strange being back here. I don't think I've been in your cafe in a while.
Almost 2.5 years. Anna kept coming in. But you stopped.
You noticed that?
I could tell you 2 tears weren't gonna make it. You broke my heart.
Well, sounds like you knew before I did.
Gotta have one eye on the customer and one eye on the books. Not that I really want to keep an eye on the books, mind you. Say, hun, would you mind if I finish this?
Oh, yeah, of course. Good luck with your book balancing.
Mm-hmm.
Now she's struggling financially like everybody else in Bath.
This'll just be too expensive.
Slicks. Coffee.
Not very inspired.
Have a sincere
little. That's not spelled right. Not even close.
Sinerly.
That's a good one.
My soul is like your coffee. It's black naturally, but with enough milk, it's milk almost drinkable. Silicon flag, flag of the biggest island in the Mediterranean. Landscape painting, Christina channeling her Italian heritage. Employee.
Hey man, thought I knew everyone, but I don't know you.
I used to be a regular a few years ago.
Oh right, you're one of those who skipped town when the mine closed down.
You could say that, yes.
Town ain't changed much since then. Same old boring Basswood. I know most people hate that, but I don't. It's quiet here. It's nice.
So quiet, there's no rush hour, I guess.
Right?
Jax, probably a high school dropout, but seems content in Basswood.
Hey man, my break's over. I gotta focus on work.
Empty shelf, unlike Christina, not empty by choice. Bored. Not.
Glad to see Joan hasn't changed too much.
Missing, no reward. I have lost a book by the title of The Grinding Gears. It's the sixth book of Tadrigrand Man series. If found, please leave with Christina. She will let you know. Thank you, Jay. Keychain.
Cowboy must have lost his keys.
The clan. Cowboy keychain. A cowboy keychain with the clan's name on it. Cops in Basswood don't go in for such. Do you think the clan chose his career path by watching old westerns? Maybe he's seen Basswood as his own personal Wild West. My best armchair psychologist says this was a gift from his fellow officer, or maybe even his boss, Sheriff Mitchell. There's something to be said for that simple conflict between good and evil. Black hat versus white hat. At least the clan knows which side he's on. The clan, that's his memento. Cupcake contest.
Christina, Always bringing positivity.
Cupcake contest. Bring your most creative ideas and delicious decorations. The winner gets 3 free dozen cupcakes. Inspire us with your cupcake dreams. The cupcake contest is back. Get ready for a cupcake. Guitar lesson.
I need to. Different priorities, I guess.
Guitar lessons. I need to learn to play the guitar. If anyone is willing to teach me, please call 5550245520. Okay, that's it, it looks like. Okay. Books had a copy of The Last Man by Mary Shelley, definitely left by Anna. Plant looks healthy, probably watered recently.
Good to see someone finally knows how to take care of a plant. It's basic, yet so many people manage to mess it up.
Working man, using graphs and deductibles, efficient. Anna. Okay, let's talk to Anna. Anna's coffee. MT prefers to drink her coffee as hot as possible.
Betting there'll be a few more cups before she leaves. Some things never change.
Sam! Glad you came.
Of course. I said I would.
I can still be glad about it. So, I hear you got in a fight after I left the wake?
More of a scuffle. He had it coming. I barely remember it.
I was so wasted at that point. It's all just a big, heavy blur.
Yeah. After saying I didn't want to drink, I went home and drank. Long night.
Yeah, sounds about right. We all deal with stress in our own ways. I apparently hit Dennis. Yeah, speaking of, you haven't seen him today, have you?
Why? Afraid your powerful blows laid him up?
So, what are you working on?
I'm working on an article on how nature does its best to reclaim the land after a strip mining operation. Why are you looking for Dennis? I can tell something has you spooked. I can always tell.
Go on, tell her. You could honestly use a non-imaginary person to confide in. She might slow me down, or try to involve the cops. She might do those things, yes, or she might be someone who you can trust, who can help.
I think so. Tell her.
I woke up today and my shirt was covered in blood.
Blood? What happened?
I don't know. Last night, pills and alcohol mixed. It's all a blur. That's why I'm looking for Dennis.
Have you tried the Basswood jungle? He likes to work weekends.
No, not yet. I'll do that right now.
Sam, is there anything I can do to help? Oh, nah. I'm just gonna do my own thing. Oh, Sam. What have you done?
I told her, right? But I thought she would tell her everything, like Dennis wanted to tell him something or stuff like that. I guess not. Okay, so meet Anna at the cafe. See if Dennis is at the Basswood jungle. And I told her everything about Dennis. The fight, the blood on my shirt, she took it better than I thought. She's worried, but she didn't freak out. Maybe things would have been different if I had learned to confide in her before. I admit that packing up and leaving town would make perfect sense, but I can't, not now, not until I get at the bottom of this. I had a million reasons not to confide in Anna, but I did it anyway. I can't tell if it was the right decision. I still need to get to the bottom of whatever happened last night. But it's strangely comforting to think maybe I don't have to do it alone. Okay, so that's it for this video. I will see you again in the next video.